On my past recent couple of fishing trips I've been on, I've seen fish that have stopped eating the jig head minnow. Guys, today in this video, I'm gonna talk about when to throw the jig head minnow and that, hey, bass will eat other lures. I've been catching bass lately on my guide trips, forward facing sonar lessons, and fishing trips by myself on a variety of other lures. And we're gonna just talk about that a little quick, okay? Cause this right here is the hottest lure right now in the country as we know for this year up. And I've had a good year with it. You probably watching may have had a good year with it, or you're watching and you're like, I don't want to throw that thing. I just hate forward facing sonar or the jig head minnow, even though people caught fish with this before forward facing sonar, okay? But guys, I mean, even for me, I've caught my biggest bass this year with it, and my personal best is right under 11 pounds. And then I've had a client catch a 12 and a half with the jig head minnow. And I've had another client, I think he's caught some fish, as you guys know. But what's happened lately, okay, guys, what's happened lately? Let's talk about a little bit. I don't know if it's the pressure, okay, of them on some of these smaller lakes I've been on. I think it's more of a timely deal. I think it's just their time of days. And fish right now, as this post-spawn period of summer, they will get more on certain baits than others throughout the day. And there's just a time where they're going to eat certain deals. Depends on your forage in your lake as well. One of the lakes I've been on lately, I'm not going to say it, I mean, I'll say it, Lake Hamilton, for example. Been on Lake Hamilton a lot lately. They ate this thing out there in the winter. But then lately, okay, we have thrown this around drops, ledges, brush piles, and what I've seen is smaller fish are coming up and chasing them. And then the better fish are behind them following too. So you're now pulling these fish off the brush pile, okay? And then when you pull them off, they're kind of in between you and the boat and the brush pile, and then they're all kind of like, eh, you know, and this lake gets a lot of pressure. So think of your lakes that get a lot of pressure too. And then it becomes a deal of like, well, hey, I mean, I like, what do you do now? You just pulled them out. And now, like Washita, we have caught fish with it still, but for me, it's been one to two fish out of a group of like 15 or so. So there are other lures. So let's talk about that. One thing I started doing with them brush pile fish at Lake Hamilton, for example, is throwing a jig at them. Okay, hey, a jig. Throw a jig. So if we see them, you know, with your forward facing sonar, or let's say you don't, you graph them over with 2D and you throw your marker buoy out. We've been throwing slower stuff in there and getting a bite. First cast or second cast, getting a bite. And it's been a quality bite. One reason it's been getting a quality bite is this is going through the brush pile. Those smaller fish are on top, and then it goes through there, guys. And then those better fish are more, it's stuck to the brush pile or the piece of cover. Grass is another one. And then it's getting that better bite. So this right here is just a football jig. It's just a V&M football jig in the Flatline series. I think it's a Flatline football jig in the Pacemaker series with the little Craw, Wild Thing Craw Junior trailer, okay? So I've been doing that. That's one thing I've been doing. So that's one bait you can throw. Another bait I've been doing, now this is what you get big bites on. Where's she at? You've been getting big bites. Okay, it's down there, but I got one hooked up right here. It's down there on that pole, but I got one hooked up right here. It's a big soft plastic swim bait. This right here is the 6-inch well. It's a 6-inch size on a core tackle. This is a 3/4 ounce 7-aught hook. So one thing I've been doing, guys, is throwing these past the brush piles, letting this sink, and then reeling them up before to them, and then going right over them, and the bigger fish are coming out and eating this. While those smaller ones are on top that you're throwing your jig head minnow at, okay, this right here is getting those bigger ones to come out. And you can do it on ledges and drops as well. Another way, I have it rigged right here. This is a 1/4 ounce hook, got me. This right here is a 1/4 ounce one, okay? This is the Zal Dangerous right here. 1/4 ounce 7-aught hook by Core Tackle with it as well for the shallower situations, okay? So those are two other lures, okay? Now another finessey one, Drew Gill, if you watch Drew, I think he's the best with live scope right now. And he has kind of like a little approach where he throws a shaky head. That's something else you can throw with these fish. He also throws a Neko rig. I have a Neko rig down here. Let me get it. So here I have a Neko rig. I cut it off. Like I said, I kind of on my spinning rods, I kind of cut them off and test things out, okay? But right here is a Neko rig. Now I have it rigged up actually with the Core Tackle Wacky Shot hook. I've just been testing it out. I'm not telling you guys to do it, okay? I got my Neko weight in there, and something, I don't know, something with the weight here and here, I thought would give it a different action as you're hopping it, you know? And I've caught a couple fish with it, but I've not just like lit the world on fire. So I'm not telling you guys to do this yet. I'm just testing it myself, okay? So a Neko rig, and I know that's something Drew, watching from the footage and him, he has that shaky head Neko rig kind of down when them fish are not eating the jig head minnow. Okay, now another lure. Really quick, guys, we're about to talk about the boat of the week that's presented by Future Marine, today's partner and sponsoring of today's video. We're going to go into the Express series, guys, and right now in the bass fishing world in general, the aluminum boats are starting to take over. The Express has a lineup in the Hyperlift series for both bass and crappie. Two great lineups to just depending what your needs are. If you're a bass fisherman and crappie fisherman, one of these boats that they have will suit you both comfortably and safe. Now today I'm going to share with you guys the H20 crappie series. It's a 20-foot boat with a Yamaha 175 V-Max 4-stroke. Now guys, one thing though about this boat I'm going to point out real quick is how in the crappie series they have the live well or bait part, whatever you kind of want to use it for, right there in the middle of the boat. So if you're out there, you're catching your crappie, you can get your bait, throw your fish in there as well. Pretty neat little compartment that they got right there for you. I know my crappie guys like to have the ice chest and have the big old ice chest, the Yetis in the boat or whatever it is, but guys, you can put them things right there. Pretty neat add-on, but whatever boat you're looking for, Express have. You're an all-around bass fisherman, they got the Hyperlift series for bass, and the ice you see now too, they got it for crappie as well. So guys, check them out today. If you want more information, go check out the link in the description. That's actually been good for me lately, okay? And it's just about that time. I'm gonna actually make a video on it here soon, okay? But it is a glide bait, okay? Something about me and my history with the glide bait. And I'm not Ben Milliken, I'm not Brandon Pollinick, Carl Jacobinson, I'm not a glide bird expert by any means. But something about me and glide baits in this post-spawn period to early summer is where it comes alive. On our lakes, we do have a bunch of brim population. We have a lot of bass that stay shallow. I know this is the white color that imitates brim or imitates a shad, okay? I do got the brim patterns. But something about this gets those bites. And even 2-pound fish, man. I've caught 2-pound fish. I caught a fish yesterday like 12 inches on this thing. I mean, this thing's 7 inches and it caught a 12-inch fish. I've caught some better ones as well. But something about the glide bait this time of year. I've caught more fish with this, guys, in the last 2 weeks than the jig head minnow. I mean, you believe it? I mean, I'm just telling you, like guys, I'm telling you, just so one thing about it is if you're throwing the jig head minnow and they're not eating it, try something else. Figure it out. Now, there is a time I know where they eat this guy, as I told you guys earlier. Here, I'm getting right here. They'll eat it. I know they will. But if they're not eating it, okay, try something different. One thing we have tried with the jig head minnow, let me put this up real quick. One thing that we have tried, and it worked one day, actually on Hamilton, it worked one day, is we already knew where some of these fish were located. It was actually off of a flat with a drop, a ledge. Okay, go ahead and tell you. No brush up there or anything. And what we were doing with this thing is I was fishing it kind of like Jacob Wheeler was last year at Gunnersville. If you go back and remember when Jake won that tournament, Jacob, he wasn't out there spotlighting fish, forward-facing sonar, like y'all want to call it or people want to call it, okay? He was fishing it more traditional where he knew where they were located, made far cast, had a count, and then would work it just like you see them work it, and it was going right over those fish off the bottom. So this one area, we already knew the fish were there. We stayed real far off of it, made the far cast, and worked it. And then all of a sudden, you feel a tick, set the hook, or a thump, set the hook. And we were not watching them on the screen. So guys, you can still catch fish using it that way too, okay? Just to let you know, that right there was a big juice right there, if I just shared any juice, okay? One other lure. You can throw big worms too, guys. I'm just saying some other lures. I'm just saying, do not count out. But the last one I'm going to share, okay, if you have watched my channel enough and know me enough and then watched last week, as I'm saying, these big spoon came out, okay? It was a player, okay? There was a week where they ate this thing. They ate this thing on like 4 lakes. Now, guys, this week, I've not caught a fish with it yet. I've been on the water twice, not caught a fish with it. But that week, they ate it on 4 different lakes, okay? So there's a time and a place for this as well. Okay, guys? Let me know what you think about the video today, okay? And what's been your lure that's been working lately? What's been your lure? Let me know. Appreciate you guys. Come back and see us on the next one.